Hello friends, in this video we'll talk about TS of spinal cord at mid cervical and mid thoracic level with the applied aspect. So what we will see, the TS of spinal cord at the two sections I told you and applied aspect. Let's see that. So actually this is mid cervical and mid thoracic section. Okay, so let's see the differences. It's very easy. So first of all, reticular formation is there in both. Okay, fine. So we will see with the anterior horn and the posterior horn. So anterior horn is little very fat and large. It is a very big and fat anterior horn. Here it is very thin. See, I told you, fat and large anterior horn. What is the opposite in thoracic? Very thin. Be very thin, okay. And the lateral horn is there in both, so no problem. Posterior horn, this is little long, this is little slender. That means this is a very thick one, this is a thin one. Remember, cervical is large and oval like this, okay. Thoracic is small and circular. So the horns which you will see in the thoracic will be very thin compared to cervical, which will be very thick and large. This fundamental point is important. I am repeating again. In cervical, please remember, since it is large and oval, as mentioned in the diagram, the horns will be little large and thicker. In thoracic, it is opposite because it is very small and circular, so it will be very thin. Okay? This is the basic difference. Let's see the applied aspect, syringomyelia. What is syringo? Syringo means central canal or cavity. Myelia is the neurons. So the neurons which are passing through the central canal, those are lesion. So it is the lesion of the neurons in the central canal involves lateral spinothalamic tract. Basic sensations will be lost in syringomyelia. Okay. So remember this lateral spinothalamic tract. Where is the lesion? Central canal. What are lost? Basic sensations. Just that point is important. So references from where I took the pictures. So this brings us to end of the video. So thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video.